Bunches. Ooh, I'm Phoebe, if you don't know. Hope you're doing okay. I don't know when I'll post this because it does not seem appropriate to be posting any sort of normal type of content given everything happening in the world right now. I don't think it's gonna add anything me trying to be articulate about the topic. I will just say that educate yourself if you're feeling, I don't know, a lot of things. I realized that while Instagram, which is sort of the only social media I'm on, apart from YouTube, is great for learning things. There's just a lot of it, and it can be quite scattery and overwhelming, and therefore you don't actually take in much information at all. So I'm going the book route, because I feel I am absorbing more information that way, and the documentary route. Last night I finally watched 13th on Netflix, and I am currently reading the free ebook, which I will leave the link below, Who Do You Serve, Who Do You Protect, which Haymarket Books Publishing have made free as an ebook until, ooh, June 5th. Well, anyway, you should go read it anyway. It seems sort of stupidly obvious to articulate into words, but I've been reading a lot of white people say, I don't want to say the wrong thing. I mean, so do I, but maybe just funnel that and all the feelings into reading, educating yourself. Yeah, anyway, I urge you to. Australia has a similar, it's not the same, it's got its own context and nuance situation. Long has read that our Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, cringed when he saw the riots, and cringe. You don't cringe, but that seems very fitting from someone who seems to only be able to smirk whether he's sharing good news or sad news or being serious. Today I'm going to go have an early lunch. It's about 20 past 11. I've just made some banana bread. Spent the morning pricking out some Brussels sprout seedlings that needed to have their own cell after germinating together. And then I need to have an early lunch because a friend and I are going to go for about 2-hour walk around Leicestershire Park near the Dandenong Ranges. I really fancied a long walk in new scenery, so we're gonna have a bit of a drive and do that this afternoon. It's not raining, it's just sort of overcast and wintry.
Yes, to say that, the police disregard the previous email that we sent, so obviously someone sent that this morning.
Ooh!
There's like a little bulge, but I'm not sure if it was a jelly or
that. Is it a bulge? Yeah. So, it might be the hugest. There's some walnuts in there too. Okay. Hey Honey Bunches, it's Friday. Haven't filmed that much this week. Not that there hasn't been some nice things I should have captured, but wasn't feeling like it. My dad and I are gonna go drive to Cape Shank, which is about an hour out of Melbourne, and do the Bush Rangers Bay circuit. It's 6K. Bit of beach, bit of trail, very beginner level, but still a nice walk. Yeah, I thought it would be nice to do that as a family. He's down this week, haven't seen him in like 3 months. So, but the rest of the family have things on. So it's just him and I. I'll try and capture some stuff. Yeah, hopefully I can capture it because it's a really beautiful part of Victoria. It's a big one. Hey again. Long time no chat. So on Tuesday, it's currently Saturday, the walk you saw, me and my friend went to Listerfield Park and just walked around the lake, which is like a 5.5k walk. Really recommend it. So many kangaroos. And then yesterday, the walk I did with my dad, Bush Rangers Bay walk, we actually walked it from the wrong point. We meant to walk it from like the lighthouse to the bay, as opposed to the spot off the road to the bay, which I've actually done like 5 times now, so wasn't exactly new, but it was nice to do anyway. I kind of wanted to do it for the added reason of getting a bit more like country driving in, or that's not really what I mean. I mean freeway driving, because I did a lot like when I was getting my hours up to get my license, but I haven't like done much solo stuff on roads which are like 100k or over. And my mum doesn't drive on 100k, and I think I've sort of like absorbed her dislike slash fear of driving on freeways, or built up how much of a big deal it is because she doesn't, you know? It's like when your parents, or if your parent has a fear of spiders and then you like absorb it. Anyway, so I just wanted to crush that and it was fine. Although I didn't drive the car I usually would, I drove my dad's car, so I don't know how helpful that was, but it was a nice walk. There's some really steep steps coming up from the beach and I'm feeling it today. I ordered some secondhand walking boots yesterday off eBay that had been worn twice, because my friend and I, while she's on holidays and going forth, would really like to do more walk. Probably really cliche again, but making the most of the natural spaces close to you is something I definitely should have done more of before this, but hopefully will be a positive coming out of it that I do more of it. And you know, it's not such a big deal hopping in the car and driving tops an hour type of thing, but to somewhere which is in the scheme of things on my doorstep, to soak that up and enjoy it. I just compiled a big list of walks and sent it to her, so hopefully we'll be doing like one a week. I felt very scatterbrained this week, as I'm sure many of you have. It's been a week. I'm filming this in the week when, well, hard to know what the future will bring, but a lot of people are not posting regular content to make a statement and put the focus of things where they should be on the Black Lives Matter movement. So that's the week I'm referring to. In making all effort to be a good self-educator, and you've probably similarly experienced this too, that yeah, you just need to get off. Have I mentioned this before? I'm getting deja vu. There comes a point where Instagram is just so overstimulating and sort of bike chunk nugget size, and I feel more long-lasting absorption of information, of history, social commentary needs to happen offline. Well, that's how I'm feeling about it anyway. So yeah, I will leave the ebook that I've been reading bit by bit this week. If you want sort of a Netflix style documentary, an absorbable one to sort of be an intro, then do watch 13th. Yeah, there's so many master lists of resources going around, better than anything I could come up with, so I'll link a couple of them below. As I mentioned, this week my dad's down, and I always forget how tiring the weeks are a bit because, yeah, we feel a lot of things. Have I mentioned this to him? So much deja vu. A lot of, like, catching up with people and fitting as much into the days when he's down. Like 3 months worth of catch-ups in a week. So I've been quite pooped on top of everything else happening. In my scatterbrain state, though, I have managed to dip into, I've read about half of it now, this book, Plant Magic, by Christine Buckley, who's a community herbalist author, and she seems to have done a whole lot of other things. I hadn't really heard of her, but I, you know, with the whole foraging plants and whatnot, it pricked up my interest. Anyway, I'm glad I, in an indirect sort of plants as a way to look after yourself, and plants that are very readily available and often deemed weeds type of way. We can look after ourselves in moment-to-moment ways. It's not trying to replace Western medicine, it's just showing the power many overlooked plants like dandelions have, for example, for skin and for anxiety, stress. Pardon my doodles, by the way, on the desk. Ooh, it's gross, but anyway. It's very beautifully laid out. Something that finally arrived in the mail was a letter from pen pal Gwenny. Your letter finally arrived in the UK. It seems to be taking the longest, because I also found somewhere where I could get an ear warmer headband type thing, because it does get a bit windy, and on cold days, I don't know, when you get wind in your ears and it hurts and it makes you not enjoy walking, I thought I'm going to be proactive and not had that sensation this season, so I found a shop on Etsy that makes acrylic ones. So this finally arrived, and my letter from a pen pal Gwenny finally arrived. Did I already mention that? My brain's just...
make an effort to get it back to her before she goes on sick leave.